first to introduce the basic geography of Australia through maps and different facts, activities, and to introduce the facts about the country. And the objectives of the lesson students will demonstrate their existing knowledge about Australia, about this country, and they will demonstrate the ability to locate specific places on the map. And they will explain the impact of location, distribution of natural resources, and population distribution of the country. Okay, before we start, what comes to your mind when you first think of Australia? Anything.
Kangaroos,
of course. Then
Sydney, the one of the biggest cities.
Yes.
Olympic Games, beach.
Sure.
Koala.
Yes, animals mostly associated with this very country.
Okay, before we start.
Okay, this is the Australia, this is the map of Australia. What does it remind you? The map of the Australia?
The dog's
head, yes. Yes, Australia is actually a big country, as you see. And the next task, you'll be handing the papers for four different groups, and you will have about 3 minutes to be prepared, and then you have to talk on your according to the papers. Okay, there are four different topics according to the Australia. Just to be introduced. Okay, you three, five of you and four of you. Okay, 3 minutes, go. Guys. Queensland and New South Wales and Victoria. We'll We'll speak about it. Okay, the first one, guess, what is that? And according to this, we will talk about the lesson.
Great Barrier Reef.
Yes, and whose topic is it?
Ours.
Okay, are you ready, I guess? It's just in short.
Okay. From our point of view, the Great Barrier Reef is one of the most wonderful places in the world. As the CNN claims that this place is one of the seven wonders of the world.
Students, just listen, because after that we will ask some questions.
And it is located on the Queensland, Australia, and we know that different kind of ships, fish, and any kind of sea animals are living there. And if you want to spend your honeymoon there, we recommend.
Did you know, guys, that the coral reef is a living natural thing?
Yes.
It's a living. Yes. It's yes. One of the biggest living in the world. Any other facts about that? It's an organism. It's one of the seven wonders of the world. Did you know? Okay, that's new for you. And at the taste, it's nice and coral. Everything is clear according to the coral, sea, and the barrier reef. Okay, on the map, we can see that it's here. Again, can you repeat where it is?
Queensland. And the east part of Australia.
Yes, that's the Great Barrier Reef on the map. Next one. What is that?
It is the Great Story Reserve.
Okay, I think it's your topic, yes? Okay, start.
It is the largest desert in Australia. It consists of sand dunes, small sand hills, and it was named after Queen Victoria by British explorer Ernest Giles in 1875.
What about territory? How much large is that?
It is very large. Its territory is 42 million
hectares. Yes.
And the distance from east to west is 700 kilometers.
Can you imagine 700 kilometers?
Yeah. And it is very dry. Because a year, it's the
rain
of rain a year is 200 or 250 millimeters.
There's very few Australians live here because of the climate, because it's very dry and very too hot to live here. Well, in the map, here it is. Okay, next one. What is that?
It's a rock, and also there is another name, it's called Bulbul, and also it's situated in Uluru-Kata, it's national park, and also it was known as a, it was listed actually in 1987 as a World Heritage because of his geology.
And can you tell us why is it red?
Because of rock.
No, it's changed this.
Why is it reddish?
Because it's iron content rocks at the surface.
Yes, iron content of the monolith is both the rock, it's on the surface, it's seen for us in the big amount. And can you imagine that it is 12 stories height? That means 12 levels. 12 level building height. So big, yes?
Bigger than our
For sure. And what about the last fact? The aborigines believe a rock is sacred. It says, who are the aborigines here?
The
native people, yes? Okay, next. Last one is population of the tree. What can you say about it?
Australia is a country in the world, and the most populous Oceanian country. And its now its population is about 25 million people, about 25 million. And by 2030, it is expected to exceed 28 million population.
And can you say what is the main reason why people live in these very sites? Actually, I'm not here. Do you remember what is located here?
Australia has semi-arid climate and steppe climate, so that's why most of people live in urban areas.
Okay, what does it mean, semi-arid climate?
Semi-arid or steppe climate is a climate of a region that receives precipitation below potential evapotranspiration, but now as low as a desert climate.
Okay, in simple, that creatures that's not populated, yes? It's not suitable for living. Here, so? Yes, everything is clear. Okay, if everybody's done, okay, let's conclude according to questions, okay? Questions about the first topic was about Great Barrier Reef and Coral Sea. Another three groups will answer. You will be silent. Okay. Okay. How many individual reefs is there in the coral reef system? They mentioned the number of the individual coral reefs. It's a big amount of both. Any ideas?
Okay.
Can you answer myself? Yes. How many individual reefs?
Individual reefs, the amount of individual reefs are 2,900.
Almost 3,000. Yes. Okay, the next question, in which state is located the coral reef?
It's
one of the six states. Okay. Actually, do you remember what is the coral reef means? What is that, the coral reef? As I said, it's a living organism, yes? So? Coral leaf. You can tell by the picture or describe it somehow.
Maybe it's a coral?
It's a living organism.
Yeah.
So it's an ecosystem. Yes?
One of the world's seven wonders.
Yes, that is the fact they mentioned. That's an ecosystem. This is different. It's simple. That's an ecosystem of different characters but different coral reefs. That's it. Okay, the next question is about Great Victoria Desert. So, tell me the distance from the west to the east.
What is it?
700. So, what this very desert consists of? They mentioned different words, yes?
Dunes, holes?
Yes.
Something like that.
Sand hills?
Mm.
And the grasslands, yes?
Grasslands,
dunes. What are the dunes? Can you say the group two?
Is a hill of sand usually deposited by aerobic processes or sometimes by the flow of water.
Is that clear?
For everybody, what are the deals?
That's a deals. Do you see? This is a hill. A small hill consists of the sand and it's called deals. Actually, the next question. Another name of air swarm. Another name of air swarm. Madina has mentioned it in the very beginning of the speech. It's actually a very unusual word because it was called by by ancient people, yes? Ancient aborigines. So, what kind of color does this very rock have?
Red.
And why?
Because there's iron content.
Yes. Iron content rust on the surface of the land, yes? Have you ever seen this very rock before?
No.
Can you, at the first sight, can you say that it is the rock?
No.
But actually it's a rock, it's a monolith, yes? Do you know what is a monolith? Monolith. That's a rock consisting of one rock.
Yes.
The last, okay, what about the population? What do you remember about the population?
25 million. More than Kazakhstan.
Kazakhstan, but the country is bigger than Kazakhstan, yes?
Space,
while the Kazakhstan is bigger.
Nice.
Okay, on the results, please. Does it taste on the world's range of population?
52 seconds,
yes. How do we call the ancient populations?
Aborigines.
Have you ever heard about them?
Yes.
What kind of activities they have taken? Do you know the
aborigines?
I know about cooks.
Yes. Cooks actually named after the captain.
Yeah.
Or do you remember? Yes. They were killing the animals, yes, like weapons like boomerangs. Do you know?
Yeah.
Okay. Which country, another question about Australia, if you remember, which country's colonial was it?
British.
We can say it according to the flag of the country, yes? It has flag in the corner.
And may I add something?
Yes, sure.
Yeah, and I know that the British people sent bad people, I mean the robbers and the who committed the crime and so on, and so that people sent to the Australia, and they had those people and they built a new country, and that's called the Australia.
Yes, that's the fact, yeah, from the history, yes?
Yep.
And as you know about the population, every sixth person in the Australia wasn't born in this very country. They're newcomers, actually. Can you imagine every sixth person in this very country? Okay, next we have some activities to do.
What about physical geography of Australia?
And you can see the picture about our signature group. The answer is on the map. So
so to the west and
by the ocean.
I sent the photo to the group. If you can see the picture well, okay.
It is the largest.
Thank you.
Have you done it? Okay, let's check together. Students, let's check together.
And the first sentence is Australia lies in the southern and it's an archipelago continent surrounded by oceans in the Indian Ocean to the west and the Pacific Ocean to the east.
Everybody agrees?
Absolutely.
Yeah. And it also can be the isolated island.
It is the largest island in the oceanic coasts, which are generally regular interrupted only by the Greenwich Group of Carpentaria to the north and the Great Australian Bight to the south.
The last two is right, but the grass is wrong. Who can tell me the right answer?
No circle? It is the largest island in the ocean with a generally regular coastline. And interrupted only by the Great Gulf of Carpentaria to the north and the Great Australian Bight to the south.
So I will read the right answer again. It is the largest country in the oceanic hemisphere with a generally regular coastline. Okay? And the next is right. The last group.
The northern thing. The northern Great Barrier Reef are characterized by the to the east, the largest coral reef in the world.
So again, what's the right answers? Shanab, can you read it again?
The largest.
The northern coasts are characterized by the Great Barrier Reef, right?
Yes.
And the third one? The largest?
The largest lakes are Lake
Oum. Yeah. Last one is largest.
The largest.
Everybody down again? Okay, we still have some time. Okay, let's play the game. Okay, can you see the map of the cities in Australia? I will name the city and you will show where it is exactly. No cheating. You can take one hint. I can tell you in which site is it located, okay? Is it clear? Okay. The first one is Brisbane. Can you show me where is it?
Brisbane.
On the east.
The east of Australia.
The east, yes.
Brisbane. On the east.
You can come and show if you want.
No, sure. Okay.
city is Geraldton?
I know, the west side.
Which city?